So you want to learn how to make the car's eye effect. These videos floating around the internet for quite a bit now of people's cars like driving during roller shots or just in general like in a shot and you can see their eyes like in cars. Well, today I'll show you how to make that effect. It's a pretty simple one and let's get started. So I've only imported about two assets here. My base layer, which is my video, and the eyes. That's all you'll need. It's a pretty simple effect. So first you'll want to get your main video into After Effects. You're gonna wanna duplicate that, which you can just do Control C, Control V, which is the easiest way. That's how I do it. And you're gonna wanna rename this one to base or whatever you want to name the bottom file, because it's like the video that's under everything that you'll see. So I'm just gonna rename it to base. And then you're gonna go on to this top one and rename them to track or whatever kind of works for you. This is the glass track that we're going to use to show the eyes in. So I just like to name this layer track. Okay, so after this, you're going to want to go and look for the effect Mocha AE, or you could also use the pen tool. I prefer to use Mocha because it's been a lot easier to make track masks for that. Let's go grab Mocha AE and drag it on here. You can also double click or whatever you want to choose. So once you're into Mocha here, you're going to want to make sure that your tracker is at the beginning, the very beginning of your timeline, because it'll cause problems if you're not there. And then from there, you just want to make a simple mask around your glass. That's about it. And then from there, you're just going to want to track forward and let Mocha do its thing. All right, once your video is tracked, all you have to do is hit X and save. So once you're back here in After Effects, your Mocha effect will actually have made a track mask. And so what's easy is that you just hit create mask, and then it might take After Effects a second here to put it in. But once it's created, then you have a mask spanning the whole sequence that follows your video. All right, for our next step, what we're going to need to do is actually track our base layer now. So what you're gonna wanna do here is go to your tracker, and then you're gonna wanna track once again, you're gonna wanna track the camera. All right, once your camera has been tracked, you want to select a couple points here. And so you'll select those points and then you'll right click and then you'll click create null and camera. All right, so now that we're here, the first thing that we're going to want to do is create a new solid. And so now we've got this. So from here, we're going to want to drag our eye preset here. And then finally, we're going to actually get rid of that for a second here. Make a new solid. And we want to match the paint. And then we'll name this eyelids. All right. So now that you've made this, you're gonna wanna have it sandwiched like this. This is where a couple things come into play. So first, you're going to want to go into your track mat, and you're gonna wanna make your track mat the track itself. That's gonna be the same thing for the eyes and for the back of the eyes. Once you've done that, you're not done yet. You're gonna wanna make these 3D objects as well so that they are all pretty much in that same kind of 3D space. And so from here, you're gonna want to make your eyelid shape. For me, I like to come out a little bit far here. And then when we come out far there, we're gonna make a little bit of a divot there, bend a little bit, come back up that way, come back out over here, and that's it. There's your eye. So, from here, we're going to want to move our eyes into perspective here. Nothing too crazy. And like, we're already kind of there, but there's a couple things we want to do just to make this sell a little bit more. So we're going to want to go over here and go for the gradient ramp and throw that onto the eyelids, because we want the colors to kind of, you know, ramp through, because if it's just a solid color, it's not going to look complete. So I like to grab colors, two different colors, a very deep color from our composition, which would be somewhere like over here, and then for our end color, somewhere in like the lighter range, and maybe something like over here, so that we have two different things. From there, you're going to want to make the start of a ramp somewhere like up here, and then the end of your ramp somewhere over here. And then once you've done that, you can kind of just mess around and look at where you kind of like it, and like right there is where I like it. Yo, like, bro, what are you doing? You haven't even hit the subscribe button yet, and you're still watching the video? Like, come on, help me out. Hit that subscribe button. We're trying to get to 100 subscribers here soon. Bouncing back, we're going to go to a track here, and we want to add a feather just to make the edges a little less harsh around the edges of the glass. You don't have to do a large or like a super crazy feather or anything, but I like to add a little bit of a feather just so that it cleans up the edges a little bit more. Nothing crazy. Same thing for this one, since we put a mask on here. You're going to want to feather it just a tad bit so that it doesn't come across as sharp. Perfect. And you can also do a mask expansion just so that it can take up a little bit more room. And then from there, you have your eyelids. And I feel like that feather is actually a little bit too harsh. So we're going to scale this expansion down a little bit and scale the feather back a little bit. You want a little bit of a sharp edge. It's kind of like up to the person's discretion, but I like to have a little bit of an edge, but not too much. So there's good. So now that we're here, we want to add a couple other things. I like to add some noise to the image. So we're going to grab our alpha noise and we're going to throw that into our track. Again, you could double click if you want, but I just kind of do that. And I like to add like 4%, just not too much. And you can always mess around with it and look at it to make sure. I like to add that noise just to help bake it in. And from there, you can just control C and then do that same noise on all your other layers. It's nice to add that noise just to make it a little bit less sharp. So the next thing I like to add to all my layers is a Gaussian blur. Now I already added a feather to this one, so I don't need it too much, but we'll add a little bit of a blur there. And then for the eyes, you want to add a little bit more of a blur, and you'll see why a little bit later. So we're going to blur the edges of the eye. Like, it's going to blur the whole eye, but we're mainly blending the edges. Okay, so you're going to want to sharpen the eyes now. It pretty much helps bake it in a little bit more, if that makes sense. You'll see people use the sharpen effect for different things. And in this case, in a lot of other cases, it helps kind of like bring it out a little bit more, but also keep it kind of like realistic, kind of, if that makes sense. So from here, I'm going to also add motion blur to all the things to make it a little bit more realistic. And from there, there isn't too much left to do. If you look at the human eye, when it's looking around, it's kind of like the eye is like jolting. It's not like a fluid, super fluid movement. So that's kind of what we want to mimic here. It's not a super fluid movement for the eyes. And so from here, we're going to set a position. You just hit P on your keyboard and open it up. So I want to raise this maybe like right there. And then we want to raise this a tad bit. I feel like the eyes are a little too small, so if you hit S on your keyboard, that'll bring your scale option. And I want to make them a little bit larger. And if you want to change the color of your eyes, I know this is something that some people would like to do, you'll want to pull up a hue and saturation effect and just drop that into your eyes. And from there, you'll just mess with this slider. And we want a little bit more of like a brownish eye. Not like red, but a little bit brown. Brownish green. That's pretty nice. You can change the color of your eyes. You just kind of mess with that slider and it'll get you where you want. From here, I'm going to also mess with our rotation just a tad bit, just to help with that realism just a little bit more. And you kind of like fine tune these things to what you like. So right about here seems to be pretty solid. All right, before we animate the eyes, let's add a couple more things. We want to add a drop shadow to the eyelids here. It helps separate your eyelids and stuff. So I'll set that up to 100 for now, just so you can see it. And then you'll make it soft after moving it away from your eyes a little bit. And then from there, you can drop your opacity back down. You don't want this to be too prominent, but you want it to be there. And as you can see from our effect, it's already tracked to the car. Pretty sick. So from here, I'm going to grab this drop shadow and duplicate it onto the eyes. Control C, Control V once again. And for the eye ones, you don't want them to be as prominent. And you want to go to, you're going to want to bring it pretty close to the eyes. You don't want it to be too offset from the eyes, because it's the eyes. And so you tweak this to whatever suits your fancy. Subtlety is the way to go. We're going to go over here and also add another gradient just to add a little bit more depth to the eyes. So from here, we're going to make the start ramp there, and we're going to want to start ramp there. And then you're going to want to change this to a radial ramp. Start your ramp somewhere in the middle, end your ramp somewhere out here. And then just kind of move it again, whatever suits your fancy. All right, so now that we're here, Now we can begin to animate the eyes. So what, I'll pull up the position there and position there. This is the easy and kind of like final part of this whole thing. So from here, you're gonna want to make sure your stopwatch is activated, and we'll go maybe like, let's say like that many seconds. It doesn't really matter the interval that you move the eyes, but I'm thinking right about here, and I'll set a keyframe there. And then from there, you're just gonna wanna like move like one-ish frame, like one, two, not too many frames ahead, and move your eyes. And you're gonna wanna move your eyelids along with your eyes. And you just gonna wanna keep that little divot in the eyes centered. There we go. And so now you can look at that animation over. It's supposed to be a pretty quick animation. And there you go. That's already your first one. And what I like to do for these is like I like to put it in easy ease and mess with the keyframe interpolation. Hit F9 on your keyboard, or you can select it, right click, keyframe assist, easy ease. Once you've done that, you're going to want to go into your keyframe graph. When you're keyframe graph, zoom in here and you've got your animation cycle right here. And it kind of depends on your preference. I like to do sharp, like ease it in and like ease and slow and come in fast. That's what I'm going for here. And so now that's an ease and slow and come in fast. Nothing too crazy. And I think I want to tweak this keyframe right here just a tad. Move it over just a little bit more. There we go. And now we've got him looking over that way. And for your next keyframe, you maybe want to go like a couple more seconds ahead of time. Set another one just to mark your current position. Same thing. Move a couple keyframes the other way. And move your eyes to where you see is fit. So I'm having him look this way. Maybe look a little bit more down. All right. Same thing with here. Have it go over this way. And since he's looking more down, I'm going to have his eyelids cover up the tops of his eyes a little bit. And so there's our next keyframe. Same thing here. Easy ease going to here. And since I did like a slow ramp in, I'll do fast and then slow. You want to add some variation to these keyframes if you want to make it look a little bit different, a little bit more stand out. All right, so from there, we have an animation looking like this. It's simple, but the eyes are moving and they're kind of doing their thing. This effect doesn't have to be like too crazy. We'll add a couple more keyframes, but it's pretty much the same thing as we just did. So I'll get back to you guys when I finish the whole animation. All right, from there, you'll have pretty much the finished product. There isn't too much more that I added to this effect because I wanted to keep it very simple. You can add whatever you'd like to this effect. And yeah, that's pretty much it. This is the finished animation of mine. And y'all might have a different outcome. Add whatever you guys would like. If there's more simpler ways of doing this, let me know in the comments. And that's about it. I'm using After Effects 2023, the newest one, so it allows us to do some more work with track mats. If you guys haven't updated to 2023, I'd highly recommend it, because for this effect, you have to use a lot more work to do so. If you guys enjoyed this tutorial, leave a like down below. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. If you'd like to talk to me more about different effects, or if there's any other effects that you guys would like to see, let me know down in the comments. I read y'all's comments and I'll reply to everybody down there. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and y'all have yourselves a damn good one.